It demonstrates the impact that engineering has on an ever-changing world.
This is really impacting the minds of young potential engineers.
It's a showcase of what Illinois has to offer.
And this one-year blip is not going to end it. It's not going to change it.
This is what they're dedicating their lives to. To inspire people from the community that maybe don't feel like they can do it too.
Historically speaking, there were a few years where it was just the electric show. So we don't know how long it's been called Engineering Open House, but the event itself has been going on for 100 years.
I've been involved in EOH for 22 years now. But you always find some really fun exhibits that the students have come up with, and it varies from year to year.
There's so many amazing exhibits that happen during EOH. Like the concrete crusher.
Tesla coil, it's been around for a while.
Last year there was a talking dog. There's all of these things that students have been working so hard to produce.
There have been lots of exhibits that I just think are really neat. I feel each year has gotten better.
Just giving people opportunities to see those things before they are mainstream. The cave back in the late 90s, early 2000s was, you know, virtual reality was budding. They were showcasing the initial technology of being able to walk in with a headset and look around in 3D. The same thing with the internet.
So that was premiered at EOH.
Yeah, yep.
That's awesome.
That was a long time ago.
In 1997, I was a student here. And I was actually involved in Engineering Open House. Basically what we did is we studied localization. Let's take this marker. If you have a building that's shaking in an earthquake, you don't want it to shake because it's going to fall down. But if you take a secondary mass and put it next to the building and attach it to the building with a weak coupling, in that earthquake, if it's designed properly, the building's not going to shake, but that secondary mass will shake and the building will stay put. And so we did that with some steel beams as the Engineering Open House project. Not much sleep going on towards the end, but I had a lot of fun and have a good experience with my colleagues.
It was the annual U of I Engineering Open House, the largest event of its kind in the country. Channel 3's Judy Sue takes us to one of the most popular competitions, the Creative Design Contest.
It had all the elements of an Indy 500. The car, the crew.
Just give me anything. All these connections just pull on and off.
The intensity and the speed.
Since about Christmas, I've been working on it pretty steadily.
The first kind of memory of EOH that I have is actually coming in high school with my like science club. I came and I was like, okay, engineering is like cool, whatever. I don't think I'm gonna ever really do that. And it was something that really opened my eyes to kind of the world of possibilities.
I actually started going to EOH when I was about 5 years old. My experience has always been kind of just being introduced to engineering through EOH. That was really my big kind of introduction into what I wanted to do. So it's really cool to be able to kind of give back and be on the other side of that.
Yeah, so actually twice when I was in high school, my brother was a student here. He's a couple years older than me. So EOH was a good time to come visit and see my brother.
So I went to EOH for the first time my sophomore year of high school, and then also again my senior year, and my sister was an exhibitor.
And go.
What? What's up? Can we get it?
Just
break it. It didn't break on me.
Oh, we're so just
over the
last few years, have you had any favorite memories or standout years that you think of?
Oh, well.
So many people are dedicated to the fact that EOH still exists every year. They come back just for EOH, just due to the fact that they experienced it in college, and they might now have kids, and they want to show what engineering is to their children.
I just love seeing the crowd, seeing those, like, the faces of young children come through in amazement at what engineering has to offer.
Kind of inspiring the next generation to come and be like, oh, I'm interested in doing that when I get to college. I want to show all the things that I can do.
I think sometimes there are some schools that don't always get the chance to have the resources to be able to do a lot of really cool experiments or have classes or demonstrations.
I think what makes EOH successful is something you don't even realize really when you're visiting, is you don't realize that all the exhibitors are students and the whole committee that plans it is all students. And like, it's very stressful, it's very busy, but it happens every year because people are passionate about it. And I think that's why it's been going on as long as it is.
Okay, James, let's see you go. We got a couple packs.
They really are able to achieve a lot when they're here, and they achieve a lot when they graduate. And so I think that's one of the keys. I always say that it's a very friendly atmosphere here at the University of Illinois for students. It's one of the things that we pride ourselves in, and it really comes out in EOH. From the administrative standpoint, we just come into play if there's something that goes wrong.
Is it going? All right, it's 10:46 on a Tuesday night. It's going to be rough tomorrow. Yeah, so that's all I got to say.